next round when compared to an equal qualified high caste Hindu name application. This is not only such study conducted. A study in 2009 in Chennai showed the lowest job application call backs are received by the Dalit women compared to other intersection caste and gender identity. Another study in 2007, I am a research scholar and I am teaching in Delhi University, so my talk is based on research evidence, so I am comparing that thing. Another study in 2007 held tracked students from their three premier Indian universities like DU, JNU and Jamia Millia Islamia as they went about applying for the job. This study revealed that the employees were extremely conscious of the social identity such as caste for the applicant, such as they claimed to only care for merit of the candidates. Additionally, papers such as those for Surendra Jodhka in 2010. Surendra Jodhka is a professor of JNU and he is a research scholar about the case study of Dalit and Muslim community and being a Dalit woman also. He studied Dalit entrepreneurs face difficulties in starting up new ventures since private sectors play a major role in attaining rent. Creating access to private network plays a major role in attaining the rent. Credit access to dealer network. Dalit entrepreneurship suffer because of lack of such a support system due to historical exclusion. This is especially true in the case of knowledge-based industries where entrepreneurship receive the industry knowledge by those of their own caste and linguistic background. None of these, of course, justify the private sector caste-based reservation on its own. That's a different debate for a different time. However, that caste-based discrimination exists in the private sector must not be brushed aside by the narrative of efficiency and profit market. Various affirmative action and capacity building measures can be evolved over time, although hopeful with urgency, but at the very least we must accept that caste identities are not as an individual as the invisible hand of the market. Second, I want to elaborate, it's in that there is a blow to end the reservation of other means. When the literacy rate is low, how will a technology-based system work? Digitization will also lead to disconnection of the masses from the core of social issues. Liberalization of Indian economy, instead, during the early 1990s, proved to be an important turning point for the country in many different ways. Under the new regime, the state began to withdraw from its direct involvement with the economy. Private enterprise was allowed and encouraged to expand into the area of economic activities and were a true node open to it. Though some scholars have pointed out that the growth of private capital in India began to accelerate during the early 1970s. It is during the post-1991 period that private capital experienced expansion and unacceptable rates. This exception was not merely in the terms of growth rate and profit. India also experienced an important ideological shift during 90s. The social rhetoric that had been so controlled on the Navarsian idea of planned development lost its charm. Market and middle classes came to occupy the central stage of India's culture landscape, displacing and emblematic village and its poor peasants. Though nearly 75% of its population continued to live in the more than half a million villages and the majority remained employed in agriculture, India began to be so caged to world through its rapidly growing urban centers, its professional middle classes and its diaspora also. Indian economics have credible evidence to show that India's growth has not merely been middle class centered and number of those living below poverty line has also been declining at a rate which is much faster than pre-1991 period. However, economic data does not capture the entire social reality. For example, the new economic policy produced the sector imbalance and the lack of agrarian sector proved tragic. India witnessed a sudden spot in the case of suicides by the small and marginalized farmer. Surprisingly, despite sufficient signal variation in the pattern of agricultural change, I can understand. I have only 5 minutes. I conclude my paper. It's happened similarly in the different parts of the country, from Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh to Maharashtra and Punjab. It is difficult to overlook the connection between the aggregate crisis and large process of economic liberalization. Given the composition of democratic system, the Indian polity had to soon respond to this crisis. Through such of it has been ability in nature, simply through the increased suicides and loan fevers. The process of economic liberalization has also been criticized by the ideological or historical marginalized section of the Indian society. The scheduled caste and the scheduled tribe, apart from the advocates from farm sector, with declining avenue of the employment in the state sector, job available under the quota system of SCs and STs have been declining. The expanding role of the private sector in technical and professional education may also be in a shrinking of the quota system in higher education. In fact, the official data is beginning to show that those belonging to the scheduled caste, tribe and Muslim majority have been experienced a process of further marginalized and withdrawn society in economic caste. I have divided three aspects: one, caste and corporate sector. What is the situation of the caste in India, and what is the situation of corporate sector in the caste-based system? I gone through that thing, but I think had not much. No? Second point, merit and discriminatory protect practice. How we increase the merit of the rich community and discriminatory practice in all the private sector and business or digitization process and other thing, the form of the living world. And third one is that our gaming and social development also, I wrote some points on that thing. Is television and social development is also a digital process. I conclude that thing also. Now I think time has gone up and I conclude my paper. The technology at one level brings parity, but at the same time ensure that core social issues are not discussed and delivered deliberately upon. Technology parity will never end the social security. It will only strengthen them. When the proliferation of technologies that are able to overcome the obstacle of the time and space, aeroplanes, cars, internet, etc., one would think that these tools would be used to gain an understanding of their culture, meet people all over the world, maintain and strengthen the female relationship, communication effective with others, and help people to become more socially adept. However, the same technology advances the cause people have to be distracted. Overall, stress and increasingly isolated, many people are involved in an abundant number of the relationship through the technology, but sometimes the quantity of this association leaves people feeling qualitative empty. Obviously, technology has had a profound impact on what it means to be the social. In conclusion, we can say that digitization drive is not taking account the real social issues. It is not striking at the root of socio-economic principal problems of the society. The technology party is not going to end this social disparity. It will rather reinforce it. Any such move without alternating the fundamentals of the social setup is not going to help much. The technology growth will not change the mindset of the Indian people. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Professor Kaushal, for actually enlightening us with the different discriminatory practices in different parts of India with education and access. Now I'd like to facilitate our Counselor General for being here and giving us this opportunity to celebrate this event here. I would like to call on Dilip and the President for the Begumpura Cultural Society to facilitate her presence here. Thank you, ma'am, for making this occasion happen. Thank you really for arranging everything for us with more time and making this happen. It wouldn't have happened without your support. Thank you.
One more. एक और Yes. हाँ जी. Yes, लुके.
कृतिपाल जी, आप पीछे रह गए फोटो खिंचवाने में. आप बहुत बड़े आदमी हैं, ये सब छोटे आदमियों का काम है. हसो.
Thank you.